Hi guys, this is Im again from Redisco.com. In this video, we are going to create simple controller for our bookstore application. You can create your controller anywhere in the app directory, but it's recommended to place your controller in controllers package. So that's exactly what I'm going to do right now. Just right click on your controllers folder, then click on new and then click on Java class. Let's name it books controller. Again, you don't have to specify this controller at the end of your controller name, but it's convention and it's considered best practice, so that's why we are going to name it as books controller. In play framework, each controller should extend controller class from play.mvc.controller. So this is the only one requirement for controller to fulfill. It should extend from controller's class, which is from play.mvc. Now let's write some methods. Public result. Let's name it index. And return to do. This is the simple placeholder for the methods that are not implemented yet. This method will be for showing all books to user. For all books, let's create method for creating a book. To create book, public result. Create and let's return placeholder, and for saving book we will create result save to do, and for editing single book, we need to create, for example, like edit method. In edit method, we will accept the ID of the book that user want to edit. For example, let's say integer ID and return placeholder again to do public result update, and this method will update this edited book into our database or some data storage. And the last method that we are going to create is for deleting. Let's call it destroy. And again, this is going to accept one parameter. That will be the ID of the book that user want to delete. Integer ID. Let's return to do again. And we also need another method to display single book. For book details, public result show, and this is going to take integer ID of the book that user want to show on the browser. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we will map these controller methods to our routes. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos.